Thank you for checking out Scotty's Hobbies. Today I'm going to be showing you the emissions component locations on this here 2011 Ram 1500 with a 4.7 liter engine in it. This is a remake of one of my older very popular videos with lots of questions, and had some audio problems in that one, so this one's going to be way better. Stay tuned, like, subscribe, and share. This is your underhood label. Right here is your emissions. Right here is the year of your vehicle, and this label also lets you know the engine size. This is very useful information when you're trying to confirm what is on your vehicle and when you're ordering parts. This might give you some information you might need for either one of those. First off, on the component location is going to be your vapor purge solenoid right here on top under the battery near the fuse box. This solenoid is responsible for allowing fuel vapors to return into the intake system and to be burnt through the combustion process and out the tailpipe, cleaned up through the cat. Hopefully, that was the plan for that. Next, here under the driver's side firewall is the PCV valve. This valve is responsible for allowing blow-by gases to be released into the intake system out of your engine, so you don't have blow-by or get excessive blow-by and oil leaks and such. If the PCV valve is closed, it will cause oil leaks everywhere, if it's stuck closed, I should say. So that allows all of those built-up vapors in the oil system to go into the intake system. I was looking for your EGR valve right there on the firewall on the driver's side. I don't know why, but I'm going to show you your Bank 1 oxygen sensors and come back to the EGR shortly. So, here on the driver's side, you have Bank 1 Sensor 1 oxygen sensor, or possibly air fuel ratio sensor. This sensor tells the computer how much fuel to give or take away from the engine to get the perfect air fuel ratio. Here are your possible codes for it. Next is Bank 1 Sensor 2. This is your catalyst efficiency sensor, pretty much. It only tells the computer how your cat is doing or if your cat is bad or not. That one doesn't do too much and should not affect your air fuel ratio at all. So, if you have any questions, make sure you comment below with your code that you're chasing, or if you have any problems. There's a lot of different variations to this truck, especially when it comes to the EVAP system coming up the end. So stay tuned, I'll go over a lot more. Like, subscribe, and share while you're watching this, and check for links in the description below for the parts I'm showing you. Here on the passenger side, you're going to have your Bank 2 oxygen sensors. This is Bank 2 Sensor 1. This is the sensor that tells the computer how much fuel to give or take away from the engine to get your perfect air-fuel ratio on the side of the engine. Next, Bank 2 Sensor 2. This is the catalyst efficiency sensor. Only tells the computer how good your cat is working, or if it is or not. So if that rear one is bad, you'll either get a P0420 for the cat being bad, or you might get a heater circuit code. A bunch of different codes could come up for your Bank 2 sensor too. Again, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share before you go too far. And if this vehicle is not yours, make sure you check out my video library or ask. I probably have a video covering that. Here on the back side of the engine, on the driver's side, up under the firewall, is the EGR valve. This valve is responsible for allowing burnt gases to be returned to the intake system and burnt through the combustion process. It causes a lot better efficiency and a lower combustion temperature, reducing NOx, which is the most harmful gas coming out of our tailpipe, I believe. So EGR valve is pretty good, but it does rob a little bit of power. So a little bit of give and take. I'm looking for the vapor vent solenoid on this vehicle. Most vehicles have them, and they're not always listed on the under hood label. So it took some time. That's why I'm a little wobbly right here. Just looking for it. But come to find out, there is not one. So if you're having a problem pumping gas and you think you have a vent solenoid issue and you're like, what is the problem? There's actually a emissions vapor integrity module at the end of the vapor canister that acts as the vapor vent solenoid. So if you have a problem pumping gas, at the end of the canister, it's not on this video, and I'm sorry about that, but I'm going to show you the canister. On the opposite end of the canister should be that integrity module. Has a little, I believe, two-wire connector going to it and a hose coming out of it. It's white, and it's up at the end of the canister. So coming up is a canister. It's going to be on the top side of the fuel tank. On the driver's side is where the fuel tank is at. So on the top side of the fuel tank, right at the center of the vehicle, is going to be the vapor vent canister. Right there. That is the bottom side or top side. That's one side. On the other side is going to be that integrity module. If your canister is bad, you should visually be able to see a crack, some type of vapors or a liquid on the outside of it. I haven't seen one go bad that didn't have a visual problem with it. So that is pretty much it on this Ram 1500 4.7 liter. If you have any questions, make sure you comment below. One of these videos right here might help you out. Like, subscribe, share, tell everybody about me, and I'll see you in the next hopefully helpful video. Thanks for watching.